I'm your last messenger. Don't look for another. And if you're looking for another one, you will be delusional. He's not coming. Behind me comes God and the executioner.
Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to another show. I'm Brother Mandene T. Muhammad. Welcome you to the Munir Muhammad Show, a CROE media production with you in mind. Always excited to be able to come on and to help disseminate and amplify the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad via this platform. This is a live interactive show. The number to call in is 773-434-6625, 773-434-6625. If you're checking us out on various social media platforms, including Facebook, please like and share the broadcast there. If it's on YouTube, please like, share, and subscribe so you'll be notified each and every time that we go live. And by all means, please check us out on our own website, crow.org. You can check the show out from there. After you get to viewing the show, you can peruse on around the website. After you become overwhelmed with all the history and information that's on there, ease on down to that donate button, and by all means, make a donation. Help CROE before you need help from CROE. And I want to congratulate. It was a wonderful film showing yesterday in honor of Messenger Elijah Muhammad's birth anniversary. Yesterday, 1972 Savior's Day was shown, so I appreciate each and every person that came out and showed their support yesterday. And also, a couple of other things. I want to make sure we acknowledge our dear sister, Amina Muhammad, wife of Brother Munir Muhammad. It's her birth anniversary is actually today. So we want to make sure we acknowledge our dear sister for the work and her dedication in helping us continue to do this work here on behalf of our dear messenger, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. So I believe I covered everything. We're going ahead and get right into it. I am super excited to have this sister on. She has blessed me once on the radio show, but this will be my first time having the opportunity to sit down and talk to her via the television show, via Zoom, however, but still, we get to see our dear sister, Sister Shahrazad Ali, best-selling author and MGT since 1967. Make sure we get that in there so we don't want no mistakes about that. So, Assalamu alaikum, Sister Shahrazad. How you feeling, ma'am?
Wa alaikum salam. I'm fine, thank Allah. This is so wonderful, and I appreciate you inviting me in on your celebration of our dear messenger.
Yes, ma'am.
The last and greatest messenger of Allah, the Most Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Yes, ma'am.
Peace and blessings of Allah forever be upon him.
Our praise is due to Allah. I am, like I said, you know, running around with Brother Munir, getting to, you know, having opportunities to see you at this place or the other, and, you know, you coming here and doing a grand opening and bless us with words of wisdom and experience. So we are grateful. I know how Brother Munir felt about you, and I know how you felt about Brother Munir. It was like biological brother and sister. You all curse each other out, but you come right back because you understood that the common denominator was the Honorable Elijah Muhammad.
Yeah, me and Munir go back 30-some years.
Yes,
and he's always been my spiritual brother, and I have several around the country, and many of them have passed on, but I have great memories of all of them, strong believers and defenders of the teachings of our Elijah Muhammad, who never defected into anything.
Yes, ma'am.
They stayed and have stayed with the teachings of the messenger, and that's how people qualify to be my friends.
Yes, ma'am. Our praise is due to Allah. So let's get into it, my dear sister. I was thinking about you and Brother Munir. We would normally, at the end of every year, we would do a show. You know, Time Magazine always talk about the person of the year. So if anybody ever watched our show, it was already a foregone conclusion that when we ever did our year-end show, that the person, or in this instance, the man of the year, and as far as we're concerned, the man of the century, is always the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And so that's our focal point, and it just so happens, although he said he didn't know exactly when his birth anniversary was, but I think somehow October 7th ended up being that day. So truly, we celebrate him every day, but, you know, for those part-timers, they get a chance to give a little extra, you know, let's celebrate the man today day. So we want to focus on the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and his accomplishments and, you know, reintroduce those that may not know so much, and, you know, introduce those that know, because with the advent of the internet, you know, a lot of the young people have been introduced to you. You know, they, you know, refer to you as auntie and big sis and all this type of stuff, and they just kind of box you in one particular area. But your knowledge is and your understanding of the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad is deep, and that's what we want to talk about today. And we want to make sure that we give you a chance to give you your flowers, because, again, being a believer in the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad since 1967 and doing his work and staying consistent all this time, it's not an easy task. You know, so, you know, you've received a lot of darts and whatnot thrown at you and ridicule all over the places. And it's one thing to get it back before the Internet, but now you got these keyboard warriors. You know, everybody got an opinion now. So, but talk about your longevity and how you were able to sustain yourself via the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, Sister Shahrazad.
Well, I think that I'm very blessed. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad said one time that the people that believe in him in the last days could consider themselves very lucky. Mm. The only time I ever heard him use the word lucky. Yeah. And I think I'm one of those people who are very lucky, because it has not been necessary to me to change what I believe in, because the times change. Mm-hmm. Just like the Quran is written for all times, the teachings of our Elijah Muhammad, they're for all times. There is no religion in America that people have that every 10 or 15 years they change the doctrine. Mm. The Christians have never came back and say, listen, his name was not Jesus, it was Raymond. And so now we're going to change that around. And Christmas is not going to be on the 25th. We're going to make it June the 1st. There is no religion where the people come in and change things around. And it creates insecurity and confusion among the believers. Mm-hmm. And we are suffering that now. The messenger has been robbed of his title as messenger of Allah. People just say, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, or they'll say that his birthday yesterday, as an example, was Savior's Day, and that he is the Christ. All kind of nonsense people have made up, changing what he said. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad spent so much time telling us, do not change one word. And you have people out here now who are changing his entire doctrine because they want to be accepted are recognized by the Orthodox Muslims of the East. The Honorable Elijah Muhammad never told us that he was teaching us to be like them. In fact, when he went there, he came back, he said that he was the black stone. He knew that. And that if you want confusion, go there. Hmm. So he was not grooming us to turn us into Orthodox Islam. But people who want to accept that way of religion, they want to change over to that. And so the Nation of Islam that we have today is not based on the teachings of Honorable Elijah Muhammad. It's some people who have just taken over his idea and practicing their idea, which I don't have a problem with. People can believe anything they want to, but I don't accept them putting it on Honorable Elijah Muhammad and saying that that's what he taught or that's where he was leading us, because that's just not the truth. He was not doing that. Warif Deen Muhammad, the messenger's own son, he is the one that brought in the new idea and got a lot of people to change what they believe, because they wanted to believe like the white Orthodox Muslims in the East. It's not a Middle East, just the East, because if there was a Middle East, that be a northeast and a southeast and a left side east, you know. So this is just something that people have also made up and got the believers confused, where most of the time when you talk to many of the young people who say they believe in Islam and the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, they don't know anything about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, because if they did, it would not be so easy for somebody else to make suggestions about him, and they change the way they believe based on that.
Yes, ma'am. Well, let's, with that being said, and with what you just said about not only the young believers, but people as a whole, our people in particular, not really knowing, let's start from there and just talk about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and just who he is.
I'm talking about him.
Yes, ma'am. But what I'm saying is, I want to go and talk about some of the things that we involved in today that we may have taken for granted for, the things that he is the father of. And
yes,
ma'am. So things that people are doing, thinking that this their idea as a whole, you know, we're talking about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad being a victim of religious persecution, or even, you know, going try to educate his own children, or, you know, even to health. I mean, those particular areas right there. And I know you're talking about the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, but I want to present this as if somebody is hearing it for the first time, because you got a lot of people.
Okay.
You got a lot of people who just don't know anything about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. You got to understand, Sister Shahrazad, you got a whole generation of young people who are not familiar, who have just been introduced to you. They're not familiar with your understanding of the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And so that's the way that I'm trying to present it today. And
Well, I want to talk about some things. You know, he had his entire history in Message to the Black Man, and our young people stay online on Instagram, on Facebook, on YouTube all day, every day. Mm-hmm. The messenger said this is up to he and she to search and seek out what he and she don't have. So I'm not going back to the beginning. They look up everything else, look that up. I'm going to bring them up to modern times right now and tell them what's going on. Now, I realize Muhammad is the first black man in America that gave us a choice of gods. Mm-hmm. We thought we were stuck with the God that the enemy gave us, and that we didn't have any choice. We didn't know there was any other God. We didn't know there was anybody else called God. Mm-hmm. Until the Honorable Elijah Muhammad told us about Allah. Mm-hmm. He changed us from what our poor parents and great-grandparents and grandparents had believed, and took them out of the slave master's religion and gave us a new idea. Mm-hmm. He did not give us a religion. He gave us a way of life.
Right.
He gave us information about diet. He said, eat one meal a day. He told us that. Mm-hmm. And he told us to fast. He told us to stop eating pork. Now, everybody's talking about fasting. Mm-hmm. They're talking about eating one meal a day. He told us to join on to our own kind, to pool your resources. People are using that. And he taught us to say all praise is due to Allah.
Yeah.
And now you got a lot of people who don't believe in his teachings out saying things like all praise is due. A Negro said to me the other day, all praises. I said, what are you talking about? Where did you get that from? What are you saying?
Yeah.
I said, you know, you won't take everything and pervert it down and make it where it doesn't have, you know, any semblance of sanity for anything we say. So he has been robbed, as I said, of so many things. Claude Anderson, a great brother who is out teaching our people about economics, he got his foundational beliefs from the teachings of Honorable Elijah Muhammad. Mm-hmm. So did Jesse Jackson, Al Sharpton. Everybody who got anything that was working for them took something from the supreme wisdom that Honorable Elijah Muhammad was teaching and suggesting. He is the first one to say, put your children in uniforms in school. Mm-hmm. He is the first one to say, separate the boys from the girls. All of those things that he taught, now people are doing as if they thought of.
Yeah.
And they did not. These are the teachings of Honorable Elijah Muhammad. And he told us, after all else fails, then comes Islam.
Yes, ma'am.
And so they tried everything else that failed.
Yeah.
You know, homeschooling. He said we should homeschool our children. Now, homeschooling is larger than public education for them. So a lot of things that he taught, which should be being taught today, he taught us how to raise our children. He taught us how to feed our family. He taught us how to behave at home and abroad. He taught us how to take care of our body. He said, you don't get nothing from yourself. We have to be taught everything.
Mm-hmm.
And so it was his job to try to do that. And Sister Claire used to mention that at night his pillow was wet. I understand why. because I'm just a woman. I'm not no leader. I'm not no man. But the Negroes will make you cry at night trying to deal with our people because we so hard-headed and love to death.
Yeah. And as you stated, Messenger Elijah Muhammad had to take us back to basics. You know, even the point of taking a bath every day. You know,
that's
just
right.
Going that, and people think that, well, you know, I don't, you know, why would you have to tell everybody to take a bath? During the pandemic, they had to tell you how to wash your hands for so many seconds so you wouldn't spread germs that way. So you got to tell people this now, you know, you got to tell people. And if you don't believe me, just go to some of these grade schools. These poor young children now, they used to teach classes on how to, you know, properly take care of yourself and learn
well,
how to cook
in
school.
We don't have hygiene classes like that anymore because in order to control each family, the different governments that have been over us mm-hmm. said that is things that should be taught at home. Mm-hmm. But they couldn't be taught at home because we went from the two-parent home to the one-parent home to the no-parent home. So the children are practically raising themselves based on the internet and other nonsense and getting ideas about how to behave, especially from the media, where they're showing young children disrespecting their parents, attacking their parents, and stealing and robbing and doing everything of what we see today in the streets.
Yeah, yeah. And you know, the disrespect, you know, there are things, you mentioned the internet, well, I mentioned the internet, you mentioned Instagram and things, but it's all the same thing. But, you know, things that we should be ashamed of are things that what people are promoting nowadays. You know, it's utterly disgusting. A pimp, Brother Munir used to often say, a pimp could get more respect than a man of God. You know, a pimp could get more recognition in this day and time than somebody that's trying to do right. If, you know, we're living in a time now where sin is glorified, and if you question the sin, then you get, as they say, canceled. You know, what say you? What are your thoughts of that?
Well, the messenger had told us that it had mentioned in the Quran that they make evil fair seeming. And so we're living in a time where no matter what you do, it's considered fair, it's okay, especially if you're making money or getting attention. Those are the things that people worship. The messenger, he gave us something to talk about. And many of the young people know about, say, Malcolm X, Minister Farrakhan, Muhammad Ali, Khalid Muhammad, Shahrazad Ali, they know about us. These are the people who are admired in the society, not because of any idea we had, because we didn't know nothing. We were blind, deaf, and dumb like everybody else here in America.
Yes, ma'am.
But the messenger gave us something to talk about. He instilled in us a bravery based on the truth and the support of Allah, where we could go out and try to spread our teachings. We are not divine. Not a one of us who are out here teaching the army Elijah Muhammad's teachings are talking about him. Just because a person is a good preacher or can speak well does not make them divinely sent.
Yeah.
We didn't have a one man divinely sent, and that was our Elijah Muhammad. And he did his best to teach us, as hard-headed as we are, easy to lead in the wrong direction, hard to lead in the right. He did his best to try to teach us and raise us up. And so I'm so grateful and thankful to Allah that I have been able to hold on with to these teachings for all these years.
Yes, ma'am. Praise is due to Allah. And that's something that is very important. And you know, the scripture says before me were thieves and robbers. And you know, when even something that Negroes have stolen nowadays, not black on black crime, you know, talking about that, that's the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. That comes straight from him, you know, talking
yes.
about, you know, kill your own black brother. You know, are you a fool? You know, things as simple as that. I mean, everything eventually comes right back around to the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, but people continue to steal from him, no matter who they are. So, it's a blessing for, you know, and it's a shame that, you know, in one sense that a sister will have to stand tall, but at least somebody is standing tall. But I wanted for you to talk about also, my dear sister, because you are an author, and we like you said, we are talking about the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. But what inspired you? What was the motivation, you know, for you to actually come on out with your series of books, you know, because they're all defending the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. But what was that actually just pushed you to the point where, you know what, I just need to do my part. I need to help amplify what Messenger Elijah Muhammad was talking about.
Munir and I used to laugh about this story, but I used to be a poet. And okay. I was writing poetry. And I decided that I would send the, at that back in the day in the 60s, you could write to the messenger and he would answer your questions and send you a letter back with his signature on.
Yes, ma'am.
He had a bunch of secretaries and they would do the mail. So you could write to him anytime, ask him anything, whatever you wanted to. So I sent my poetry to the messenger, and because I was proud of it, and I thought maybe he would put something in the Muhammad Speaks or something. So I sent it to him, and he sent me back one sentence in a letter.
Yes, ma'am.
He said, "Dear Sister Shahrazad, I am not concerned with poetry." Listen, I didn't write another word. That was the end of that career.
Yes, ma'am.
But I still wanted to write. So that's when I started thinking and looking around to see what else could I come up with, because the poems I had written were about the nation and uplifting the people and things like that.
Yes, ma'am.
But then I decided to write in 1985, I wrote a How Not to Eat Pork or Life Without the Pig. And then that opened up the door for me to gain other knowledge and to write the my first bestseller, which in 1990, which was The Black Man's Guide to Understanding the Black Woman.
Yes, ma'am. All praise is due to Allah. And
is my QR code up?
It will be in a matter of seconds, yes, ma'am. But we're showing the books. We are showing the books, and also your Cash App will be up. I got you covered, Sister Shahrazad.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Okay. Look here. I already told you. I came up on the Munir, so I can handle anybody else now. So all praise is due to life. If you have a question or comment, and I am surprised that it's not a call unless they're not monitoring it. But if you have a question or comment, the number is 773-434-6625. Again, the number is to call in if you have a question or comment for our dear sister, 773-434-6625. And you know, Sister Shahrazad, you know, we try to make sure that every time we come on the show, we present it as if this is the first time somebody is seeing it. And,
yes, sir.
You know,
yes, sir.
And the Honorable Elijah Muhammad has been overlooked. So, and you gave the fine example, you know, of, right? We love the students, but, you know, we overlook the teacher. We love the cake, but we don't like the ingredients. But it can't be like that. And you can't compare them to any other so-called leader out there nowadays, either nowadays or back in the days. Because if we look at if you go to a barbershop, they're always debating about who's the GOAT. And basketball and whatnot, and it's back and forth. If we're talking about wins and losses, we're talking about victories, we're talking about somebody that's more accomplished, we can't speak of anybody else but the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. But it's a part of his teaching that says that, you know, they don't talk about the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, because when you mention the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, it raises the bar of leadership so high that you can't mention anybody else. You're wasting your time.
I think what happened, had the messenger, this is just me speaking now,
yes, ma'am.
Had the messenger just told the people, don't eat pork, don't drink alcohol, don't smoke cigarettes, not because you're helping God, because it's helping you.
Mm-hmm.
If he had just told our people that, many more of them would have probably tried to hear what he was saying or join on back in the day.
Yes, ma'am.
But his real issue that our people took objection to and still do today is that he identified our open enemy as the Caucasian people.
Yes, ma'am.
And our people love the devil because he gives them nothing. Yes. And so they didn't want to give that up, and they still don't. And they say things like, well, you know, he teaches racial superiority. So does the enemy.
Yes, ma'am.
That's why every statue is white. Every courtroom got pictures in there that's white.
That's right.
Every biblical figure, every God that they got is white. They teach racial superiority. He taught actual facts about the black man being the original man, the maker, the owner, cream of the planet Earth, God of the universe. The devil has made us ashamed of that. Mm-hmm. And our people are embarrassed that anybody would think that they are of God.
Yes, ma'am.
And so we deny that. When I've looked at many times, I say that the messenger gave us a way of life. So we can compare the two ways of life. The Christians and the religion that the white people forced on us, we didn't come here as Christians. That was not our base religion of any black person on the earth. It wasn't enough of them to spread that around the entire earth at that time. They didn't have airplanes and jets and things to do that. So they taught Well, we believe. Yes, let me, you're right. Let's act like there's somebody that just got into this. We believe that God is a man. The mission told us that God is a man. Nobody was interested in the affairs of man but God, another man. Mm-hmm. He taught us that there was no life after death. Death is the end. You go back to the earth that you came out of. He taught us that do not love your enemy. Okay? Yes, he said, don't do that. That's not good. You know, shouldn't love your enemy. He said, do for self. Do something for yourself. Try to get separated from your open enemy. He told us that. He said, respect your women. Take care of your, you know, defend and take care of your family.
Yes, ma'am.
He told us to eat the right food. Eat one meal a day. He said, pool your resources and do something for yourself. He told us all of those kind of things. And he told us that a great scientist named Yakub was fooling around in the laboratory and did scientific tests to make a man. Mm-hmm. And that he grafted each color of the black people lighter and lighter skin together until he made a weak bone, stale face, evil person that he identified as a devil. Mm-hmm. That is the open Caucasians that we see today that still killing our people in the streets day and night. He told us about those kind of things. And he said that they would rule for 6,000 years. And then our God, who was already on the planet, would come back and prove that he could destroy them in one day, bring their entire structure down, and that he would not do it with guns. He did not need us to be out in the street rioting.
Yes, ma'am.
And that Allah would take care of all of that. He said that we had a mothership up in the sky that had been up there since the early 1930s, and that it was monitoring things. And when the time come, it would drop bombs into America, and that America would burn for 1,000 years. Mm-hmm. Now that's basically what we believe. Mm-hmm. Now it's a lot of things in that, but that's basically what we believe. Mm-hmm. We believe in Allah, who came in the person of Master Farah Muhammad. We know that that's not the same Allah that's been here for 76 trillion years, which is as long as the black man been on the earth. The messenger said, but one dies and another takes his place, and you already know the difference. Mm-hmm. And so that's the guy we believe in. Now, that may sound a little strange to people who have been hearing something else their entire life.
Yes, ma'am.
That may sound a little strange. Now, that's what we believe in a nutshell. That's not everything, but those are just a few points.
Right.
Now, the religion that they taught us to believe in is that a woman was walking around, she was dating a man, but they wasn't dealing with each other, and that some kind of way she ended up pregnant by mm-hmm. an unknown person, mm-hmm. and she had a baby, and that baby was named Jesus, and then he grew up and decided that the people decided that he was going to be the God, and that he was the three in one. He was the Father, the Son, and the Holy Ghost, mm-hmm. and that he would die on a cross where some other white people killed him, and that in 3 days he would rise from the dead and float up in the sky with wings on his back, a lot of people around him with wings on their back, mm-hmm. and that then he would come back, and that he died for our sins, and he would save us all. He was a brother that could do a lot of things. He fed a lot of people with 3 fish and 2 pieces of bread.
Yes,
he walked on water. He did a lot of things. So now when you compare what the Christians believe and what we believe, neither one of them sound plausible
if
we go by our limited understanding of reality.
Teach.
So what we believe ain't no more crazy than what the white man taught us to believe so that he could use us as a tool and a slave and control us. Mm-hmm. And people need to look at that. Ours is no stranger than what they taught, which is just as strange. But I would rather believe that my God is black like me, mm-hmm. black like my father, black like my children. That's the God I want. I want a God that looked like me. Yes, I want a God that loved me for me being me. I don't want to go up under a God that looks just like the enemy who has robbed and raped and pillaged black people for over 500 years, actually 6,000. Mm-hmm. So that's what the messenger taught us, to look at self. He wasn't no psychologist. Negroes out here now talking about, he was a psychiatrist. He knew what to say. He knew what to say, and he knew what to do.
That's right.
And he was not just, he was suffering the same way the rest of them.
Yes, ma'am.
The black man was suffering because he had a wife. Sister Clara was a good sister. Mm-hmm. All right?
Yes,
the messenger didn't call us no queens. Now, so I don't call her no Queen Clara. He said we was a queen, but he did not call us that. Sister Clara, because she loved her children like all of us do, she helped create some of the problems. As good as she worked for hard for him over the years, she helped create some of the problems that the messenger ended up having out of his children, especially Wallace. And so when we look at that history now and the things that, you know, he had a hard time. And he is the strongest black man that I've ever seen because he never quit on us. It's nobody can deal with black people that don't end up quitting on them. I don't care who they say they is or what they believe in.
Yes,
because we are so hard-headed.
Yeah.
We are so hard to lead to the truth.
Yeah.
We are so, you know, people claim that they love Malcolm so much or they love Khaled. Oh, that's a lie. Because if Malcolm was here, if Khaled was here, Muhammad Ali was here, any of them that was teaching real good back in the day, because of the new technology, every other Negro in America would be saying, well, I don't think you ought to do it like that. Well, I don't think you should say that. I think you ought to do it like this. Because we don't agree with no leader. We want a dead hero, because then we can say we believe with no accountability.
Yeah, we just a bunch of fans, really. 773-434-6625. It looks like we do have a caller. Caller, you are on the air with Sister Shahrazad Ali.
Assalamu alaikum, brother, and assalamu alaikum to salam. Sister Shahrazad Ali.
Wa alaikum salam.
Hey, I'm a big fan over here in Chicago. I want you to know that, sister. You have, over
the
years, been a staunch, stalwart defender of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. I salute you, sister, and I want you to know that I remember meeting you at CROE many, many years ago when you presented that big check, and I was just... I'm so happy to just be in your presence. So I'm not going to belabor the. I don't have a question. I just wanted you to know that I respect you very much for who you are.
Assalamu
alaikum, brother and sister.
Wa alaikum salam. Thank
you.
Was there another caller? No caller. Sister Shahrazad, I want to take the break, give you a chance to catch your breath, take a sip of water, and make sure we have all your information up there so they can know how to support you and get your books and things. So what we're going to do, we're going to take a break, and then in that vein of the messenger, we're going to go and hear from him. So we're going to take this break, and we'll be back.
So it's the screen freeze now.
I'm charged with the delivery of the message. Not a one of you is charged with that, because the message was given to me. And if I have 40 million helpers, they all, every one of them is helping. Not that they are responsible for the message. If you read the Quran and Bible, I'm the only one God will hold responsible for you not getting the truth. Because he gave me the truth, and the way he gave it to me like a flowing spring, like a flowing fountain. The fountain have enough drink in it to give everyone drink that come to drink. You don't need a new fountain. Just try and drink up what this fountain is.
And we are back to the Munir Muhammad Show. I'm Brother Mandene T. Muhammad. enjoying a wonderful, wonderful conversation with our dear sister, Sister Shahrazad Ali, best-selling author, MGT since 1967. And this is a live interactive show. The number to call in is 773-434-6625, 773-434-6625. She don't do interviews often now, so when she do, consider it a blessing. So we appreciate this. We appreciate the wisdom that she's displaying right now, and she's showing that she studies. And you know, Sister Shahrazad, I recall once, I believe it was a conversation, I don't know if it was on there or off air, you and Brother Munir, because he was asking you, in effect, you know, because the importance of even you know, brothers teaching the sisters, you know, about the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, because a lot of times, you know, you get some Muslim men, they just as bad as the Christian men, and you know, they just want a dumb woman. You know, they just, you know, these are the women that's going to be raising your children. So if you got an ignorant person, you know, no matter what they believe in, then you're going to end up having some ignorant children. But you were talking about the importance of being taught correctly by that person, yes, that you're involved with.
Yes.
Yes, ma'am. So, go ahead.
It's very important. See, one of the reasons many of our people have found it easier, and some of these people have not even been in the Nation of Islam, but our people find it easier to maybe accept the Orthodox Islam, because you can wear old scraggly beard. You can wear all kind of old dusty old clothes. You don't have to clean yourself up. You can do a bunch of rituals. You know, you can do a lot of things. And that's what Clarence 13X tried to do with his so-called 5%ers. You know, they wanted to learn some Islam, but they wanted to be able to have great big afros, any kind of clothes on, walk around all dusty like him, and smoke marijuana. They had some heavy science with the alphabet. They could do that and still be accepted as a Muslim. See, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad made us and taught us to clean up. He gave us enough information that we wanted to clean ourselves up. He said the first thing that Islam do for you is that it dignify you. It straighten your back. It lets you stand. It let us be a protected woman. It give us something to do, how to act, how to behave, how to walk, how to sit. He taught us everything about how to be civilized and be recognized and respected by other nations on the earth. We don't have that now because so many of our sisters, in their desperation, have made the porn industry so popular and practiced so much filth on these internets and Facebooks and Instagrams that a lot of people around the world think that's the black woman in America. And that is not us. And that's one of the things that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad did. He taught us as black women how we are supposed to present, how we're supposed to behave. And I look at the sisters in there now. Being an MGT is not being a Delta. It's not being in a sorority. It is a class to teach civilization, how to take care of your husband and family, and how to birth and raise and nurse your children.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, ma'am. Oh, praise you. Know, go ahead. I'm sorry.
Wait, let me finish this. This is important to me.
Yes, ma'am.
Okay. We are getting right now, getting ready to come up on Ramadan in December.
Mm-hmm.
Now, as black people in America, we didn't even know there was no word called Ramadan.
Mm-hmm.
And it's two words that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, and if anybody can find it, show me, never mentioned to us or taught us. And that word was Ramadan Mubarak and Juma. He didn't tell us nothing about that. He just said Ramadan in the Eid. Because if it had been important, he'd have told us that. He told us that our Ramadan is in December and that he chose it for us to remind us of the ignorance we used to practice in celebrating Christmas and Jesus being born on the 25th. Around angels and all of the other nonsense of drinking and eating hog and all of the stuff that we have been taught in this country to do for Christmas. You know, the black eyed peas on New Year's Eve, the chitlins, the ham, all the hog we could swallow, the whiskey, the wine, the beer, all of those things.
Mm-hmm.
So he gave us December, told us it's not really a fast because you're only supposed to be eating one meal a day, but you're going to eat that one meal after sunset, which in most cities is about after 5 or 5:30. He said there would be no liquid during the daytime, no water, and no land meat at all. So that means we could just eat certain kind of fish or just vegetables, which he had suggested anyway.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, what we have today out here are people who are celebrating Ramadan 3 and 4 times a year in order to be accepted or recognized by the white Orthodox Muslims in the East. That's wrong. That's not the messenger's teachings, and that's not what he told us to do. We don't have no four Ramadans. We have one, and he taught us entirely how to do it and how to eat to live and why we should do it. Mm-hmm. No fighting, no quarreling during that month. A lot of rules he tried to give us in order to put us on something that would give us a standard, be a reminder every day, and increase the betterment of our health. That's what he tried to teach us. So we get ready now to have the Ramadan of the followers of our Elijah Muhammad. Now the people that have another Ramadan in April and June and October and all of that, those are not believers in the teachings of our Elijah Muhammad. He didn't teach us. He went over there. He didn't come back and say, you know, eventually I'm going to turn y'all into them. He didn't tell us that. He didn't teach that. He didn't say he was the Christ. He didn't teach no nonsense like that. And I'll tell you something, Nadine. It's a lot of people in the so-called New Nation of Islam who say a lot of things, and they teach a lot of nonsense that they wouldn't dare have told the messenger. You couldn't have got Farrakhan to go to the messenger and say, listen, I don't really think you the messenger of Allah. I think you the Christ. And I think I'm special. I'm the one really divinely sent. And, you know, I don't believe in Farrar Muhammad, you know, but we will believe in Prophet Muhammad 1,400 years ago. You couldn't have paid him. There's no amount of money, gold, or diamonds you could have gave Farrakhan to go tell the messenger that. But once the messenger passed, Negroes start coming out being themselves and picking up all kind of nonsense, all of that nonsense that Wallace taught. And he even talked to people. He told them that it said in the Quran that if you go to somebody's house and they serve pork, so you won't insulting your host, that you should eat the pork. See, you got to be careful with this so-called teachings on the Quran. The messenger gave us the Malana, Muhammad Ali edition. However, just like there are thousands of Bibles, there are thousands of Qurans. So you got to be careful which Quran you're reading, because if not, you might get some of them silly teachings that Wallace tried to put on the people and get them to do what he was saying to do. All of that was to destroy the foundation of the teaching.
Aged. I'm just looking at you. You look so beautiful. And thank you for coming on and inspiring us. And Brother Mandene, we miss you on VON. You know that. Now I know where I can find you once or twice a week. So thank you. Excellent work. That's all I have. Have a great rest of the weekend. Thanks again. Bye bye.
Thank you so much. Yes, ma'am. You know, we got and I appreciate the call, Sister Michelle, and Sister Shahrazad, she bless you with I mean, rightly so, with those comments, and how to eat to live is so very important to our people. Yes. And again, as you stated earlier, as something else that they tried to rob the messenger of and give without giving them his just due. And also, and we see what's going on in this day and time as far as, you know, just, and really what you're giving us is fundamentals of the Honorable Black Mob. It's basic fundamentals that would keep us alive. And with that being said, even as far as survival kits, the Honorable Elijah Muhammad talked about that as well.
Yeah.
How important it was to have a survival kit in your home. And now this, you know, people are making a living off of selling that.
Right.
But expound on that.
Well, he hasn't been wrong. It's things that happen all the time. He hasn't been wrong. I do think that just like he recognized the Savior, that I recognized him. And I believed what he was teaching. And he was such a beautiful man. As I said, a lot of things people saying and doing today, they would have died and went to hell before they put that in front of the messenger. Because he was too great and too powerful for anybody to bring the kind of nonsense that they're tricking the people with now. Because the people are still blind, deaf, and dumb. They, like I said, they in a club. They dressing in a costume. And I always come back to this because it is what helped to destroy the Nation of Islam that the Honorable Elijah Muhammad had built. When his son, Warif Deen, came in and changed everything in 1975 after the messenger had passed in that February, and the people got with his idea, he, of course, after several months, he had talked the people against what the messenger has been teaching. And he told them he was going to give them the new Islam, which was that God is a spirit and that there's life after death. He had prayer beads for them. They believed everything in the Bible and that nobody's ever seen God. God was invisible, and love your enemies. And the devil is just an evil idea floating around. Now, that is not no new religion, Mandine. That's the same religion that the white people gave us in Christianity. The tenets are exactly the same. That ain't no new religion.
Yeah.
The Honorable Elijah Muhammad had the only new idea, and he referred to it as the supreme wisdom. He said, take your Islam and make it work for you. And everybody who has taken any part of the Islam he gave us is successful.
Praise
he said, you'll know my followers in the last days because they will be the successful ones.
Oh, praise
he understood Lord. That he was around a bunch of disbelieving hypocrites, lowlife robbers and thieves that was robbing the people of the knowledge of themselves and the knowledge of God and the enemy. He was not dead to any of that. And so you got the people out here talking that nonsense, but he's still alive. Because our people want a trinity. They want life after death. They want to believe in Christianity. And they can't accept that the messenger was not a trickster. He was not a liar. He did not come in here to trick us again after what the devil had did to us. He is not nowhere peeping at us talking about, yeah, they think I'm dead. That is the most ridiculous thing I've ever heard. But you got many of our people who believe that. It's a secret belief because they can't put it out there because it'll get shot down. But many of them still believe that. And that's wrong, and that should be put straight. And another lie that's out there being told. If somebody out there lying, talking about they've been up on the mothership, that's a lie. The messenger didn't even say he'd been on the mothership, and if anybody was qualified to be on the mothership, it would have been the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, because God sent him. He didn't send all these other Negroes that's making up things to get the people to honor them.
We have a few minutes left, Sister Shahrazad, and like I said,
is the time up already?
Yeah, well, you know, it's 58 minutes an hour, but you know, like I told you, it goes by pretty quick, and you know, I'm grateful that you took the time to come on and expose.
Oh yes, sir. I'm always available to come on and honor our dear messenger for the hard work he put in that eventually took his life. The messenger said, we don't have no set time to die. And the only way to escape death is not to be born.
Yes, ma'am.
And so when his time was up, he had completed his job. It was a hard job. Like, I'm just a woman. God didn't send me. I'm not divine just because I can teach on several different subjects because he qualified me to do so. That don't make me special like that. That make me the me feel like I'm honoring the messenger's legacy and that I'm turning to Allah so that he will turn to me and my tribe. That don't mean that I'm the one that nobody should get behind. I'm telling you what he said. And the moment I start trying to tell you what I said, like a lot of the people out there doing, that's when they run into trouble, and that's when they start lying, and that's when their ego get out of hand.
Yeah.
We don't have to take credit for it. The messenger says it's always somebody out there trying to take another guy's credit.
Yes, ma'am.
And that's what they're doing to him. And using his name to shield their filthy religion that they have made up and took over his program and tried to change it all around to make them somebody great.
Yes, ma'am.
We didn't have but one great, and that was the Honorable Elijah Muhammad, the last and greatest messenger of Allah. And if they never say it in that so-called Nation of Islam they got up there in Chicago or anywhere else, he is still the messenger of Allah and the only one that even told us there was a God named Allah.
Yes, ma'am.
So I'm never going to sit by and let people come against him and lie on him, and I hear about it, and I don't speak up about it. But as I said, I'm just a woman, so I can only do so much, but I'm going to do that part as long as I can.
Yes, ma'am. In these last couple of minutes, if anybody, you know, want to take the time to call in, 773-434-6625. A lot of these, the younger people, they're familiar with you. As far as it's difficult to come on, for you to come on, and you know, not so much, I don't want to diminish you to relationship advice, you know, you're not, you know, dear Abby, but in the spirit of the teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad and, you know, building a strong family, how do we do that, Sister Shahrazad? How do we build that strong black family? And, you know, is that the reason why, part of the reason why our family, our people are in such disarray now?
Well, I'm glad you mentioned that. We have to have a head in the household. The messenger gave us some direct instructions that help us to form relationships, like be civilized in your asking and telling. Sometimes playing is harmful. Stop forcing yourself into places where you not wanted. Want for your brother what you want for yourself. Pool your resources. Work hard. Don't make excuses. See, all of those are guidelines about how to live every day and get along with somebody. He said that the man is the head of the home. He said even if he is the junkie, yet he is the head. Yes, and so he was first trying to teach us what the enemy had taught us to do, which was to disrespect our man. To disrespect the father of our children. Yes, and ma'am. I want to mention this about polygamy. There was not supposed to be any polygamy in the Nation of Islam back in the day. Because the messenger, I wrote to the messenger, that's another level, Mandene, I wrote.
Yes, ma'am.
And the messenger wrote to me, and I lost my mail. I can't believe I can't find my mail. Anyway, he wrote to me and he said, "Dear Sister Shahrazad, again, the black man in America can't handle one woman." Islam lady. That's all he wrote to me.
Yeah.
So I understood, but the messenger knew that there were brothers out here trying to have more than one wife. And I'm going to tell you why. Because in the instruction to the laborers in regard to becoming a minister and some other posts, the first number one thing on the list was he must be the husband of one wife. So if he didn't know that was going on, why would that be a requirement in order to be a minister?
I get you.
See, so he knew what we was doing.
Yes, ma'am.
We was blind. He wasn't.
Yeah. So we got about 2 or 3 minutes. There's another caller. Call him and try to squeeze you in. You on with Sister Shahrazad. You got a question or comment?
Assalamu alaikum. I just want to say to our sister, what does she have to say to her critics? I mean, whether they be male or female, black or white, you know, about her stance. There's one brother in Detroit who tries to belittle her, but she stands way too tall. He's a midget compared to her. But okay. I would like to say, ask her, what does she say to her critics? And
brother,
I'll be gone.
Thank you
for an awesome show.
Thank you.
Brother, I say the same thing the messenger said when they came and told him about Malcolm. Just leave them to Allah. I have not offended anyone. Those people in Detroit, I've given them donations, thousands of dollars to help them. I love them. For years, I had tried to support them. But you know, the messenger say, envy and jealousy destroys from within. So I don't have anything to say to my critics. I'm just grateful to Allah that he is blessing me with all kinds of riches that he is doing. And I'm thankful to Allah. He has allowed me to see my great-grandson. Praise Allah. So yes. I'm blessed today. I don't have anything to say to my critics. They need to go and look in the mirror and criticize themselves, because Allah is blessing me. And that's the rule I go by.
And as we close out, Sister Shahrazad, tell the people how they can get your books and how they can support you.
Well, I put my my QR code should be on your site. That gives my site where you can go and find my books.
Mm-hmm.
You have to look for me, though.
It has been
up. And my Cash App should be on there, too.
Yes, ma'am. It's been shown now, but I just in case, you know, Negroes blink and they nod off, but your voice rings loud, so it's nothing like hearing it also. But as we close on now, we got 1 minute. Just go ahead and give us a closing statement, my dear sister. And again, we thank you so much for coming in.
As I said, I'm thankful for this opportunity to help celebrate our dear messenger's birthday. He was such a wonderful, beautiful man. He carried that light that y'all talk about, that the Muslims have, that shine and that glow. Oh, he had it. It was really, really like that. I saw it with my eyes. And so I never got to go to Chicago, but I'm so grateful to Allah that he let me hear these teachings. It has been my life. It continues to be. It gave me a way to live. It gave me a way to survive. And it has given me money, good homes, and friendships in all walks of life. Freedom, justice, and equality. And so I'm grateful for that. Okay. And if you want some of that for yourself, get with the real teachings of the Honorable Elijah Muhammad. You ain't got to join nothing. The teachings belong to you. You in the Nation of Islam. The earth belongs to Allah. If
yes,
you
ma'am.
On the earth, you in the Nation of Islam. So you can go and get this yourself. You ain't got to go pay nobody. You ain't got to do none of that.
You said it right there, Sister Shahrazad. They give me the rapping sound. So the church music is playing. Thank you so much, Sister Shahrazad. On behalf of the PRO organization, CROE, co-founders of the CROE Media Production Team, is my dear sister Shahrazad Ali and brother Mandene C. Muhammad. May Allah continue to bless you with the light of understanding as I greet you in peace. Assalamu alaikum.